Mindy Kaling not only portrays the lovable Kelly Kapoor and the mysterious Mrs. Who,
it's too strong for our light.
She's also an accomplished writer, producer, comedian, and activist.
I'm very, very pregnant.
Welcome to MsMojo, and today we'll be counting down our picks for the top 10 Mindy Kaling moments. Before we begin, we publish new content every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. For this list, we're going over the things that make us fall in love with Mindy Kaling over and over again.
After you finish this, we have the main event.
Number 10, Wreath Witherspoon. If you've seen the third season of The Mindy Project, you know exactly what we're talking about.
You're lucky I let you put up that wreath.
Wreath Witherspoon? This is the nicest thing in your apartment.
Mm-hmm.
Wreath Witherspoon is a Christmas wreath adorned with pictures of the Legally Blonde star. It was an immediate hit with fans, spawning a plethora of DIY recreations. Because of this, it quickly became one of the most memorable moments of the show. After all, it is the nicest thing in Danny's apartment. But did you know that in real life, Kaling gifted a version of Wreath Witherspoon to its namesake? That's right, in 2015, Kaling made the gift in light of Witherspoon's Oscar nomination. How awesome is their friendship? Number 9, her relatable tweets. These days, it's hard not to get addicted to celebrity Twitter. Well, we've got your next fix. Mindy's feed is the perfect combination of poignant and hilarious. She rants about Game of Thrones, supports her friends' projects, and even comments on the oddly sexual artwork hanging in her hotel room. You'll fall in love with her admiration for Malala Yousafzai, and her friendships with her co-stars. Since Kaling is a new mom, our fingers are crossed that baby pictures are on their way. There's something for everyone on her feed, and you could easily scroll for hours. Number 8, her promotion of body positivity.
I don't know, like I've gotten pretty bad advice about needing to be skinny to be on TV.
Mindy Kaling is a refreshing presence on screen because her look isn't one we're used to seeing when it comes to leading ladies. She embraces her appearance and acknowledges that putting such a huge emphasis on women's bodies shouldn't be normalized.
And I'm like, whoa, who's that smoking hot babe?
Yeah, look at that. That looks...
She has the perfect perspective and has been quoted as saying that she's totally fine with identifying as, quote, cute and chubby. In a world where women are constantly pressured to look and act a certain way, Kaling's confidence and self-acceptance is not only a breath of fresh air, but an inspiration to women of all shapes and sizes.
I'm feeling like I could only be on television if I was very thin.
Number 7, the Serious Ladies panel.
I feel sad when people say, like, you were the first person that made me feel like that was possible.
At the Sundance Film Festival's Serious Ladies panel in 2015, Mindy Kaling offered many inspiring views on reproductive rights, being marginalized, and being a role model for young girls.
I find it very sad. So many girls who look up to me or are interested in me are young women of color who have been told that they are ugly.
During a discussion with fellow panelists Kristen Wiig, Lena Dunham, and Jenji Kohan, she spoke on the topic of the young fans who look up to her and offered some words of inspiration for them. This insightful advice is exactly why it's so important to have diverse representation in the media we consume. And Mindy Kaling has become emblematic of a move in the right direction.
Women who look like me or who look like different than me find themselves like that they can be beautiful or be objects of love and attention and affection.
Number 6, her attitude towards motherhood.
I'm so excited to be here. Thanks for having me.
I'm so excited to have you here, and you're carrying a child with you.
Carrying
so
a child.
And your child.
Yes, thank you. Thank you.
As the world becomes more progressive, we learn that the term family has many definitions. Even before she became pregnant, Kaling felt a strong need for motherhood.
Okay, if anyone was going to announce big news about your private life, Oprah Winfrey is the person.
Right.
She was very close with her mother and craved to recreate that bond. She said, quote, I would love to be married, but it's not a necessity, like the way that I feel I need and want to have children.
Well, as you know, it's so easy to criticize parenting until you're a parent. So one of the nice things about becoming a parent is that I'll be able to openly criticize other parenting.
When the news broke that she was pregnant, many media sources waited for her to reveal who the father was, but she never did. She now has a beautiful baby girl and notably left the father off of the birth certificate, embracing single motherhood.
I'd like to be the fun mom. I know I'm gonna be the dorky mom, so if I could be kind of fun too, I think that would be nice.
Number 5, her refusal to be an outsider.
Give her a break. I mean, she has a long line of virtues, chief among which, forgiveness.
Diversity in the media is possible because of people like Mindy Kaling. However, there comes a point where we focus on the diversity and not on the art being created.
I could spend my entire life doing panels on being a chubby woman of color writing a TV show. And everyone, it would be useful to some people, but I wouldn't be writing my TV show.
As Kaling notes, straight white men aren't asked the kind of questions she is asked on a daily basis. These questions are important, but focusing on differences and labels does nothing to put people in question on equal ground.
I have a personality defect where I sort of refuse to see myself as an underdog.
She's proud of who she is and who she represents. However, Kaling wants to compete directly with those straight white men, and she's proven time and time again that she can.
I often am reminded of it when people ask me why I'm confident or why I do this. I'm like, why wouldn't I be? I mean, this is because of my parents thinking they raised me with the entitlement of a tall, blonde, white man, I guess.
Number four, her standing up to male writers.
I will say that it helps the show be, I think, a little bit more feminist when there is a woman who is a feminist running it. It just makes things a little bit easier.
So often, women are taught to shrink down, apologize, and ask permission. Kaling, however, refuses to be talked over. Because of that strength, she inspires many women in male-dominated careers to follow suit.
I remember being terrified and silent for most of the first season.
Oh, really?
But if you ask any of those guys, they were like, you were not terrified and silent at all. You were expressing your opinions loudly.
For example, Kaling's fellow office cast member, Jenna Fisher. Fisher once asked Mindy for advice about being taken seriously as an equal in the male-dominated writer's room on the show.
Remember how it felt when he cheated on you, though?
Which time?
Kaling's response was, quote, if you can get them to yell at you, then you know that they're treating you like an equal and not like a girl. Fisher took the advice and loved the results.
And Ryan puts me through so much drama. So I guess I just have to decide which of those is more important to me.
Number three, her work on The Office.
You guys, I'm like really smart now. You don't even know.
Would you ever guess that Kelly Kapoor had such a large influence on some of the most memorable moments on The Office?
I talk a lot, so I've learned to just tune myself out.
Mindy Kaling directed the episodes Body Language and Michael's Last Dundies, served as an executive producer for the last couple seasons, and wrote some of the show's best episodes, including the Dundies and the iconic Niagara, co-written with Greg Daniels. The episode Diwali even featured her real-life parents. Kaling left a deep imprint on the show, paving the way for her eventual position as a showrunner on The Mindy Project.
You're not Mindy, you're a warrior, and your warrior name is Beyonce Pad Thai.
Number two, Matt and Ben.
All that you and I want is what?
Meatball subs.
Not right this instant.
Before she found fame, Kaling and friend Brenda Withers wrote and starred in an off-Broadway play, Matt and Ben, in which Kaling played Ben Affleck. The play asked the question many had in 1997. How did two Hollywood unknowns come up with the award-winning Good Will Hunting?
We are gonna be so rich.
We're gonna be so famous.
Totally famous.
I'm gonna meet Steven Spielberg.
Kaling and Withers comedically suggest the script fell right into the actors' laps from their apartment ceiling.
Would you believe a package would fall from the sky?
From the ceiling.
Into our laps.
How does a package fall from the ceiling?
But it did.
That's the thing, it did.
Critics praised the duo for their witty jokes and characterizations. The Office's Greg Daniels saw the play and later hired Mindy to write and act for the NBC show. It proved to be a great beginning to the rich tapestry of Kaling's career.
If I had created a website with this many problems, I'd kill myself.
Number one, her willingness to break boundaries.
What are you doing?
Come here, help me fill my bra with wine.
Mindy Kaling is a trailblazer. There's no doubt about it. Among her many accomplishments, she was the first and only Indian American woman to star in and run her own network show, as of 2014.
Women, especially young women of color, want to see someone on TV who is not playing a terrorist or someone in IT.
She was featured in Time Magazine's 100 Most Influential People in the World in 2013, and once told Reese Witherspoon, quote, I've never had anything that I didn't create for myself. Kaling paves the way for minority women every day by showing off her multifaceted talents.
I hope that young women look to me, Mindy Kaling, as a role model and let me play the characters I want to play.
Because of people like her, we are a step closer to living in a world where diverse representation is the norm and not the deviation.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from MsMojo and subscribe for new videos every day.